Good evening and welcome to Lincoln Cathedral for this service of choral Evensong as we celebrate the first Evensong of St. Simon and St. Jude. We extend a particular welcome to our friends, the choir of Romsey Abbey, who are singing our services for us this weekend. If you are joining us online, the service can be downloaded from the Cathedral website. The service now continues with the office hymn, which is number 214, and you will find in the green hymn books. Now please be seated as the service continues with the psalms appointed for this evening, which the choir will sing. They are Psalms 124, 125, and 126. And you can follow these in the black prayer books if you wish.
Thank you. first lesson is taken from the book of Deuteronomy, the Song of Moses, chapter 32, starting at the first verse. Give ear, O heavens, and I will speak. Let the earth hear the words of my mouth. May my teaching drop like the rain, my speech condense like the dew, like gentle rain on grass, like showers on new growth. For I will proclaim the name of the Lord, ascribe greatness to our God. The rock, his work is perfect, and all his ways are just. A faithful God, without deceit, just and upright is he. Here ends the first lesson. The second lesson is taken from the 14th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the 15th verse. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me, and those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. Judas, not Iscariot, said to him, Lord, how is it that you will reveal yourself to us and not to the world? Jesus answered him, those who love me will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words, and the word that you hear is not mine, but is from the Father who sent me. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Here endeth the second lesson.
I believe in God.
On the right hand of God, Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to
Congregation is now invited to be seated while the choir sings the anthem appointed for this evening, Locus Ist by Bruckner. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for all your saints, and tonight for the lives of Simon and Jude, who are dubbed as the patrons of lost causes. We believe that nothing is ever really lost with you, but sometimes to us, it seems that way as hope fades in our hearts. So we hold before you tonight all those victims of the recent mass shootings in Lewiston, Maine, in the USA. We remember the dead and the injured, those mourning and in hiding for fear, and for the perpetrator of this crime. And we ask, loving God, that you will grant healing and resolution for all. Lord Christ, we thank you that you chose as your apostles some ordinary and obscure people such as Simon and Jude. Teach us by their example that it is more important to be faithful than to be prominent, and to help us serve you at all times with holy and humble hearts, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Bless blessed Jesus, you reminded your accusers that the first commandment is to love God. And we do that best by loving our neighbour. But you also challenge us not to be selective in choosing our neighbour, and that sometimes it is our enemy who is our neighbour. These will be hard words for anyone in Gaza or Israel to hear. But we pray for a time, both there and in our own lives, when all people made in your image, whether we like them or not, are loved as neighbour. Lord God, Creator and Father of us all, you have made of one blood all races and nations of people. Increase among us the spirit of sympathy and understanding, of tolerance and goodwill, that the prejudices, arrogance and pride which cause division between those different nations may be done away with, and all peoples may live together in unity and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray, as at Evensong every day, for Stephen, our bishop, for bishops David and Nicholas, and for our Diocese of Lincoln. And today, in particular, we pray for the parish of Market Deeping, which is currently in vacancy. So we pray for the people there and for whomsoever is called to serve among them. In the worldwide Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the Diocese of Antsarinara, the Church of the Province of the Indian Ocean. We pray too for the life and ministry of this cathedral. And on this particular day of the month, we pray for the wider foundation partnerships, for the schools that are associated with this foundation, with Lincoln Christ's Hospital School, Dayaston School in Market Raisin, together with the schools attended by the cathedral's choristers and chanters. We pray too for the members of this Cathedral Foundation of the Blessed Virgin Mary, both living and departed. And among those who died on this day in years past, we pray tonight for Nicholas Babworth, who was prebendary of Tame and bishop successively of London, Salisbury, Bath and Wells, who died in the year 1427. Also for Thomas Mannox Sutton, prebendary of St. Mary Crackpool, sub-dean of Lincoln and sometime canon of Westminster, who died in 1844. Also for Herbert Thomas Parry, prebendary of Welton Westhall, and the first Archdeacon of Lindsay, and for 43 years, rector of Bigby, who died in 1940. Also for Hedley Robert Burrows, prebendary of Sutton and Morisco, and vicar of Great Grimsby, later Dean of Hereford, who died in the year 1983. And so we use the prayer laid down by St. Hugh for the daily use of the canons of this cathedral church. Almighty and eternal God, you are Lord both of the living and the dead, and have pity on all those whom you know will be yours in faith and works. We humbly beseech you that those for whom we have determined to offer our prayers, whether the present age yet holds them in the flesh, or the age to come has already received them out of the body, may of your merciful goodness come to pardon of all their sins, and so be held worthy of eternal joys, through our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. And we We join all these prayers together as we say together the words of the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. No collection is taken at this service, but there will be an opportunity for you to contribute to the Cathedral Music Fund as you leave, should you wish. Our closing hymn tonight is number 195, which you will also find in the green hymn books.